Welcome. In this video, we'll take a look at posts, which are individual articles or other pieces of content that usually appear on the blog page of your site. To create a new post, click the Write button in the top toolbar, or go to My Site, Posts, and select Add New. First, add a title. Then, just start typing to add some text. At the end of the paragraph, hit the Enter or Return key to create a new block below. Click the black plus icon to choose from a list of your most commonly used blocks, or simply type a forward slash and start typing the name of a specific block. For example, let's add an image. In the image block, you can upload an image file from your computer, select an image from your media library, or your Google Photos. Or you can search for free images from Pexels. When you find one you like, click the Select button to add the image to your post. Then continue adding blocks to create your post. When you're happy with your content, click the gear icon in the top right corner to open the settings for your post. And let's take a closer look at each of these. Status and visibility lets you change some basic information about your post, including who can see this post once it's published on your site, and whether your post will be published immediately or at a different date and time. If you want, you can stick this post to the top of your blog, even after you publish other posts. And if you have other authors or editors on your site, you can mark this post for their review, or assign a different author here. And of course, you can move this post to the trash to delete it altogether. If your theme supports it, you can choose a different template or layout for your post. The permalink is the URL or web address where your visitors will view your post. It's a good idea to assign your post to a category so your visitors can easily find related posts within the same category on your site. Tags are another way to help your visitors find other posts on your site that contain the same keyword or tag. You can also choose a featured image that represents the content or mood of your post. The featured image usually appears on your blog page and lets your visitors know what the post is about. Likewise, an excerpt is a one or two sentence summary of your post that usually appears next to the featured image on your blog page. And finally, you can choose whether or not your visitors can comment on your blog posts and allow pingbacks, which are a special type of comment that's created whenever someone links to your blog from their own site. When you're happy with the settings for your blog post, you can save it as a draft or preview what it will look like on a desktop computer, tablet, or even a mobile device. And when you're ready for your post to appear on your site, click the Publish button. WordPress will prompt you to double-check the settings for your post. And if everything looks all right, click the Publish button again. And now your new post will appear on your site as the newest entry on your blog page. You can copy the link to your post to share it with your audience, or view the post on your site. For more help writing blog posts, please visit WordPress.com/support.